Glad you could make it. I don't know if you've been to one of Ian's Valentine's Day parties before, so let me let you in on a few things. We're going to have drinks in the parlor, probably some charades by the fire. Let's see, what else? Hey, right here, okay. Other than that, make yourselves at home, have a good time, and Ian should be down shortly.
Oh, hey, there you are. Your timing could not be better. Now we can finally get this Valentine's Day party underway. Hey, Neil, hit me with that theme, man.
Oh, you got it, Ian. One, a two, a one, two, three. Drinking with Ian. Feeling a little love. It's Valentine's Day, so snuggle up with your loved ones and have a drink. It's lots of fun. It's fun. Get drunk drinking.
Hey, everybody. It's good to see such a beautiful group of people here tonight. Neil, how you doing?
I'm pretty good, Ian. We've got a great show lined up for you tonight. You know, it's taking place here in this fine home. And let me tell you something. It's a little something, a special edition of Drinking with Ian, a very special, cozy Valentine's edition that we like to call Drinking After Midnight. Ian here has gathered together a lot of his close friends and a lot of real top drawer kind of people. So why don't you settle in and join us and, of course, you know, our favorite party people, you! So now, the one, the only, Ian.
Hey, everybody. Like my friend? No, please, keep going. That's why we invited you, yeah. Perfect. All right, we have a swinging little soiree for you tonight. It's Valentine's Day, as you know. What better way to celebrate Valentine's Day than to get drunk around other people? Here to do that, let's go to our friend, our bartender of the stars, Mr. Ollie Stench.
Hey, everybody, how you doing? Crappy Valentine's Day to all of you, because I'm bitter and jaded and single. And in honor of that, tonight's shot is called The Happily Ever After. And to make a happily ever after. To make a happily ever after.
After!
Fucking retards.
Retards.
I did mutter Jesus Christ under my breath, too, so you could say Christ.
Christ.
There you go. Okay.
Go!
You take a shot.
Shot!
Of UV lemonade flavored vodka.
Vodka!
You take a shot.
Shot!
Of UV citrus vodka.
Vodka!
Stupid speed pour on me. Speed pour my ass.
Ass. Speed.
You take a shot of 7-Up.
Up!
And you take two shots.
Shots!
Which aren't going to fit in there.
Air!
Of cranberry juice.
Juice!
That's a really large shot, Ollie.
I told you, I'm single.
Single.
Got to get through those lonely nights somehow.
Somehow.
Pour it over a little bit of ice.
Ice.
And the happily ever after. Shots on the house.
Yeah, you have no idea how many bottles of Pepto-Bismol I had to go through to get these shot glasses.
That's funny.
Very honorable of you.
Thank you.
I love the
gift.
It's going to be a lonely night.
All right, everybody, on three, the happily ever after. One, two, three, salute! Ah, taste sensation, not too bad, huh? All right, everybody, as you know, Drinking with Ian's known for having our shots, and we're known for having our shot girl. Here we have the leader of the shot girls for, I believe, how many seasons have you been with us?
All but one.
Yeah, so about four seasons with
all
us.
But
we have.
Half.
Well, she's been with us for a long time, and is proof. She has the Drinking with Ian tattoo. Ladies and gentlemen, the leader of the shot girls, Maria Dunn. I know, you're marked permanently with that. How did that, affected your livelihood? I assume it probably has a little bit.
Yeah, I've been suffering.
Yeah, that's good, but you suffer for your art.
Absolutely.
So you've been, like I said, you've been doing this for about four seasons, and do you have any great memories, I assume? Handing out the shots, what kind of weird stuff's happened to you?
Aside from being pawed at, hands down my shirt, the great tips.
Really, so the Drinking with Ian crowd is actually, sexually assaulted
yeah,
you on.
Yeah, a few times.
Wow, okay. It's kind of hard to be act all swanky when we have that. Yeah, okay. So, and now do you look at this as a bad part of the job?
No.
Really?
I don't mind.
Well, because you're just inviting more people to do it now. That's not necessarily the smartest thing to do. But seriously, so you've been doing this for a while. This is good. And we normally do this in the First Avenue main room, and tonight we're doing it in a little bit more of a laid-back environment. What do you think about the party so far?
I love it. Mm-hmm. This is great. It's an intimate setting. A lot of good looking people here.
Yeah. I say they're the best audience on earth.
Oh, absolutely.
So you don't come up with any weird calluses on your hands. I mean, this hasn't done any weird chemical burns from the shots that Ollie has made or anything strange like that?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. No chemical burns. Every night that we do a taping, I do go home a little drunker, a little stickier.
Yeah.
But otherwise.
Drunker and stickier than your normal night out or just a little bit? All right. Speaking of drunk and sticky, we have, Steve, right?
Yes, I do.
Steve the furry guy is wandering around here. Let's go check in on him.
I'd like to see you in a chicken outfit, and then out of it, then probably back in it again.
Hey, it's Steve. How you been, man? I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, kind of a rough night so far.
How's that? This is a great party. As Prince would say, this is the jam of the year. You gotta be having a good time.
I keep getting shot down. It's yeah? just like prom. I remember that year, Mom lost a job at Pizza Hut and...
Hey, look, it's Scott Brady.
You know, you're a very beautiful
camera,
woman.
Probably.
All of you, I have to say. Not like the ones I'm used to. I mean, last night, for example. I mean, I've been with some girls whose heads have wanted to put bags over, but never a plastic one. I mean, her unibrow met in back. I'm serious. And it was obvious she'd never given a hand job before either. I swear she could barely get all my fingers in her mouth. It was very awkward. By the way, I wanted to spell the myth that all Catholic priests molest altar boys. Not true. For one thing, I wasn't even Catholic. Or technically a boy at the time. But I was altered. Rather significantly, I have to say. I'm addicted to online porn. Did I mention that? Which is kind of sucks because I do not even own a library card as of last Sunday. But I recently took one of those online surveys. You know what I mean? It turns out I'm a metrosexual.
Wow.
Yes, I will screw anyone in the 7-county area. That includes Ham Lake and East Bethel, by the way. I'm serious. I'm just as surprised as you are. Of course, my girlfriend thinks I'm overly obsessed with role play and fantasy, which is a ridiculous thing for her to say because she doesn't even exist. But I once made the mistake of calling a woman a cheap whore. Bad idea. Yeah, it turns out that is just about the worst thing you can call a whore. Remember one time a prostitute came up to my hotel room dressed in a cheerleader's outfit, and I told her she reminded me of my old high school girlfriend. I said, oh, is she a cheerleader? I said, no, a prostitute.
Oh, Scott, you're too much. How you doing, everybody?
See
you again. Scott Ray. Fantastic. How have you been doing this in town?
Fantastic.
You've been doing the stand-up here in town for a while now?
A little while.
How's it been treating you?
A little rough, but...
Well, it seems like you have everybody entranced over here. I'll leave you to business. There's somebody I want you to meet.
Outstanding.
Come here. Oh, this hot tub was a great idea.
This was an awesome idea.
It's a fantastic idea.
Yeah. Hey, nobody here to hang on. How about... So too.
Oh, that's a fantastic idea. Oh, and I love this song.
Yeah. All right.
You're just full of good ideas. Oh, you know what? Just in case our hair gets wet, I brought this blow dryer.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Blow dryer hair.
Some toast.
Oh, toast!
Yeah! Yes,
toast is an awesome idea!
Yes!
Oh, that's a fantastic idea. Hey, you know what will go good with that toast?
What?
I'm throwing some chicken breasts in my George Foreman grill.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh, perfect!
Yeah,
oh,
I'll make some sandwiches.
Yeah. Oh, awesome!
Great idea.
Oh, this is the best ever!
Hey, everyone. This is a friend of mine. Her name is Alexis McKinnis. She writes a little column for the Strip, and specifically for Vitamin, right?
Mm-hmm.
And since it's Valentine's Day, we had her here because her column deals directly with sex. I know, not a bad gig.
Not a bad gig at all.
How'd you find yourself in this?
Well, I have a pretty popular blog in the Twin Cities.
Okay.
I've done some other freelance writing, and some of the people that were starting up Vitamin said, hey, can you write the sample column? And I said, sure, and I did, and they loved it, and that's it. One a week now.
And when they approached you, did they approach you to write a sex column, or just came out of all of your pores, and you're like, have to do, well, hell, we saw that, but you should really be talking about sex.
Specifically for a sex advice column.
Okay. And how long have you been in Vitamin now?
Let's see, we had our 1-year anniversary in November.
Okay,
so
very nice. And what's the feedback been for this? So you've now been on billboards, right?
Billboards, buses, bus stops, the whole, yeah.
And I assume that means that there are a lot of creepy, creepy men trying to track you down. Because whenever you see an attractive woman on a billboard and sex involved, especially when she's local, yeah, not a good thing. Is that right?
Yeah, it's all over email, too. Like, no one talks to me at the bar. No one approaches me at the restaurant when I'm out with my friends, gas station, nothing. It's always like I get all these really weird emails.
Yeah,
so
those people are called nerds.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Hey, what started you blogging, and then how did that lead to blogging about the hoo-ha and the wing-wang?
Well, I feel like I've been blogging for a really long time.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, 7 years maybe. And then there was always some sort of like sex-based relationship content on my personal blog.
Okay.
And then that just kind of sparked the interest of one or more people.
So this started off firsthand, where it was your sex in particular.
Yes.
Wow. And I assume boyfriends, loved ones, whose wing-wangs and hoo-has you're familiar with, I assume they read these. What did they think about all that madness?
Well, as far as my column goes, they're pretty supportive, although I do have one ex.
Really? No, that's bullshit. So, I mean, honestly, if I stuck my wing-wang in your hoo-ha and I'm reading about it on the Vitamin, I'd be like, hey, too much wing-wang in the hoo-ha about me right there.
Yeah, I have one ex.
And they're actually, and they have been supportive, so you actually have decent exes.
All but one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, all but one.
And, all right, well, bated breath, everybody. tell me about this one, yeah.
Well, he just calls BS on my column all the time.
Mm-hmm.
He'll call me up and be
that
like,
stand for?
Like,
BS. That's bullshit. Okay, yeah, all right, nice.
He's like, you don't know anything about that. What are you talking about? But
specifically, what does he think you don't know anything about?
How to keep a healthy relationship, specifically.
Oh, that was like much more boring than I was hoping for.
Like, when I give relationship advice about how to keep your partner happy,
mm-hmm.
how to keep each other happy, he calls BS on that, but obviously I'm a lot happier without him, so I know a thing or two about
him. Well, yeah, you dumped his ass, so what the hell's he know, yeah. Now, you're from around here, right?
Yep.
So that means your parents are around here.
They are.
What do the, you know, the folks think about all of this little action with their little lady on all the billboards around town talking about sex?
I don't think my dad reads my column. My mom...
Which I think would actually be creepier if he was. Like, mom's like, you are so right. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think my dad reads it. My mom reads it at least every other week, I call
on.
They're supportive. My sister won't go anywhere near it. She's freaked out about the whole thing.
Why is that? Is she some weird conservative freak?
She's just my really protective big sister, you know.
And the big world's already got to you because you're in Vitamin.
Exactly.
Talking about wings and hoo-has.
Which I know a lot about. You know, just write what you know, that's what I do.
And you know about sex. Speaking of which, a man who embodies sex. I want everybody to give a rousing round of applause for one of our main party goers, Haiku Jim.
Hey everybody, how's it going? Yeah, I do have a haiku for you tonight. I want the men in the audience to just use your imaginations on this one. deserted island. A woman washes ashore. No, it's Rachel Ray. Hey, I could do another one if you want. Do you want another
yes.
one?
Yeah.
All right. All right, you're on. Okay, another one. Okay. Like the first spring tulips, my lust will never be quelled. Premium, je t'aime. What do you think? Hey, thanks, everybody.
Yeah, capital effort.
Enjoy your night, capital. Man. Enjoy your night tonight. Thanks for
love
coming
by. Love Haiku Jim. Look at that. He's great. All right, I hope you like Haiku Jim. Something else I want you to see that's really important are our sponsors. Why don't you watch this right now?
You'll save money and time. You'll get the best of merchandise and service when you patronize these good neighbors.
Drinking with Ian is proud to be sponsored by gold medal winner UV Vodka. No matter if it's UV Blue Raspberry, UV Red Cherry, UV Green Apple, UV Ivory Vanilla, or UV Orange Vodka, UV flavored vodkas offer a premium product without the high price tag. Please visit uvvodka.com for additional information and recipes. And please remember to always enjoy Philips products in moderation. There are a few things in life more fulfilling than drinking alcoholic beverages while watching a TV show about drinking alcoholic beverages. The folks at Pizza Luce would like to make your current DWI experience even more awesome. You may ask yourself, or those around you, how can I possibly have a greater time than I am? Well, if you order Pizza Luce delivery right now, we can assure you that within about 30 minutes, you will be having the time of your life. In fact, our studies have proven that watching DWI while eating tasty Pizza Luce pizza will make our already super delicious pizza taste even better. We don't know why this show makes our pizza taste so good, but we think that Ian's crazy hair might have something to do with it. No beer in the Midwest has a grander brewing tradition than Grain Belt. For over 100 years, Grain Belt has been the beer that fathers have passed on to sons and friends have passed amongst each other at local bars and watering holes. It is a beer with tradition that spans generations, which is why it has become legendary, both here and across the country. Next time you go out, ask for a premium. If there's one thing we like better than booze, it's cheap booze. And that's why we chose Merwin Liquors as the official Drinking with Ian liquor store. Great deals, a huge selection. They even have a contest where customers can win free drinks for a year. Merwin Liquors is hard to beat. Yeah, it's a bit ghetto, but up your street cred and save a buck or two. Stop in at Merwin Liquors at Lindale and West Broadway in North Minneapolis, just two blocks west of 94, or visit MerwinLiquors.com. A portion of Drinking with Ian is sponsored by The Onion, America's finest news source, and The AV Club, bringing you reviews and commentary on the arts and entertainment scene. Available at newsstands throughout the Twin Cities and online at theonion.com and avclub.com. Drinking with Ian is nothing without our sponsors. Please support them.
No, the suit comes off.
Really?
No, not really.
Steve, how you doing? You enjoying the party? This is quite a swanky soiree. I'm glad we got this many people together. I mean, it's February. It's cold outside, right?
Man, I struck out in extra innings, my friend. It's just like my whole life.
This. I mean, really. I mean, it seems like you have everything. You're a good-looking man. You're a sharp dresser. I mean, why would you be having these problems?
It's just always been that way. I remember back when I just turned 18.
You gave me salmonella poisoning, you bastard.
You're the one that said you liked it raw.
I just can't stand being cooped up in this relationship any longer.
Strip poker.
But it,
no, we're not.
Want this blow?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Then there was my third year of college.
Hey,
to be.
That's why I kind of switched to this and stopped drinking beer, because, you know, it starts ending up a little bit awkward. Oh, hey! Our friend's here. You guys have been introduced, right? All right, this is Ellen and Patrick here. Why don't you guys hold the mic, by all means? They're old friends of Drinking with Ian. Amazingly enough, probably in our first season, during our second taping, I'll let them tell the story. Why don't you guys kind of bring everybody up to speed here?
All right, well, the episode had a game called Let's Make a 40-Ounce Deal.
And ironically enough, it's the only bit of Drinking with Ian that was so bad, we cut it in its entirety.
Maybe it'll be a bonus clips for this episode, or this season.
No, it won't.
Well, we had a lot of shots that episode. It wasn't just the one shot you get with normal episode. We had at least 3, maybe even like 18 shots that episode. And Ellen, who I'd met 6 months previously and asked out, and she turned me down and forgot who I was, suddenly found me much more attractive after 18 shots, which you would too, but...
I do right now. And if you guys sober couldn't stand the sight of each other...
No, sober I would never have dated him. However, drinking and drunk...
With Ian.
We had our first date.
And then they went on a date the next day, which is awesome.
Yep. We went to Napoleon Dynamite, 11 a.m. showing.
I wonder how that night went. Yeah.
Needless to say, we spend half the movie in the bathrooms. And
not together.
We've been together ever since.
And now.
And thanks to Ian, because or else it would have never happened.
And now, with your beer hand, quite accurately,
we
actually brought a couple together who went into holy matrimony. And you guys have been married for how long?
2 years in March.
And they've actually managed to stay together. How much better is that? And that's why
I'm drinking with Ian.
And so everybody, I mean, you know that this is great. You know, I mean, this is great. I'm just so happy we managed to actually bring two happy people together. You guys don't seem to be seething or angry or anything. Speaking of which, let's go check in with our hot tub cam. It's going to be spectacular, trust me.
Wow, what a great idea. I could die happy right now.
Totally.
Hey. You think we should have all this stuff in the hot tub? What's the worst that could happen? Yeah, it is.
Shark!
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 Oh,
I'm a shark! Oh, no, 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 shark! I can't do anything with my ears full of shark! Oh, that's terrible!
Maybe you can help me settle a bet. I need you to be the egg, and we'll see who comes first.
My fourth year of college, but I, you know, this party's kind of a drag, you know? You wanna get out of here? Get some White Castle? Okay, let's go.
Really? That's, I don't wanna hear about that. That's depressing is what that is. Hey, do you hear this music right now? This isn't too bad. Oh, you're probably wondering who's playing right now. It's our friends GST. They're going to play a little song for you featuring our friend Neil. Let's check them out.
Smile with my heart. You're photographable, yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak? Are you smart? Don't change a hair for me, not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine, stay. Each day is Valentine. Funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with your heart. Your looks are laughable, unphotographable, yet you're my favorite work of art. Don't change a hair for me, not if you care for me. My funny Valentine, stay.
Chanteur of the Stars, Mr. Scratchy Face Neil Schultz. Thanks for showing up to our party tonight. That's Drinking with Ian, Drinking After Midnight. Hope to see you next time, all right?
Yeah!
I'm in love, L-U-V.